السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته. الله أكبر الله أكبر. الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاة. حي على الصلاة. حي على الفلاح. حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، نحمدك اللهم سبحانك كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك وعظيم سلطانك. نحمدك اللهم آناء الليل وأطراف النهار، معترفين بسلطانك، حامدين شاكرين لنعمائك. ندعو الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يديم علينا نعمه ظاهرة وباطنة، وأن يلهمنا العزم والعزيمة والصبر والثبات على أن نحمده على تلك النعماء. اللهم آمين. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يحيي ويميت، وهو حي لا يموت، وهو على كل شيء قدير، شهادة قامت بها السماوات والأرض. ندعو الله سبحانه وتعالى ألا يحرمنا إياها لحظة لقائه. اللهم آمين. وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه، أدى الأمانة وبلغ الرسالة ونصح الأمة وكشف الغمة، وتراكنا على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك. اللهم اجزه عنا خير ما تجزي به مرسلا ونبيا. اللهم شفعه فينا شفاعة لا نعذب بعدها أبدا. اللهم اسقنا من حوضه شربة لا نظمأ بعدها أبدا. اللهم أمين. محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم طب القلوب ودواؤها، وعافية الأبدان وشفاؤها، ونور الأبصار وضياؤها. صلى عليك الله. Not to learn from Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم from his seerah, but also literally I mean it, we live with him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ya Rasulullah, in that historical event took place 1443 years ago, the hijrah from Mecca to Al-Madinah. Live it with him. Live it with him. And understand what he did, what he has sacrificed for, what he has struggled for, along with the few of the Sahaba in Mecca and Al-Madinah. Migrating from Mecca to Al-Madinah, as we all know, after 13 years, where half of the Quran, or almost half of the Quran, was revealed to him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Mecca is no longer at that time the safe haven to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Sahaba. They had to leave from Mecca to another safe place, safe haven place for them to continue with Islam, with the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it was in Medina. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prepared for it, as we all studied and as we all know, and migrated from Mecca to Al-Madinah, and there keeping in his mind, deeply in his mind, his heart and his soul, three foundations to establish the new Muslim community. As we all know, one, Baytullah, Taqwa Allah, learning the way of Allah, learning Islam, learning the Sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and apply what we learn. Two, establish the real and true brotherhood and a sisterhood between Muhajirin and Ansar, those who are coming from Mecca to Al-Madinah. Third, establishing Dustur Al-Madinah, a constitution to govern the life of Muslims on one side and non-Muslims at that time on the other side, the Jewish people in Medina, other tribes in Medina, the pagans, Al-Mushrikeen, Al-Kuffar, you name it, how they can live together peacefully. We have seen in details all of these factors. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam decided to establish the first community under his leadership and how it was established, subhanallah. We came to the conclusion last week, sharing with you that taqwa Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wal ikhlas, taqwa Allah wal ikhlas, two major components of the first foundation of the Muslim community in Al-Madinah. In order to establish that spiritual relationship between Muslims, believers, the Sahaba, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Learning from the Quran mainly. Yet it was only half of the Quran. Yet it was the Sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, just living with him only for 13 years, not 23 years, as we will see, inshaAllah Rabbil Alameen. Taqwa Allah, fearing Allah, abiding by the rules and regulations of Allah, teaching Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala first and foremost, nothing else, nothing from my own, nothing from your own, nothing from someone else to tell me, here is how you live your life. No, it is the taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we learn this in our masajid, from our ulama, from our imams, from our scholars of Islam, and so on and so forth. Especially, you know, if we have some specific issues we have to discuss in the masjid. Ask, bring it up. Say, here is the situation we're in, how we can deal with. A lot of people nowadays say, oh, we have the internet. I have my iPhone. I can find out a lot of things. A lot of people did, but most of the time, there is no precise answer. You'll find different answers. As we all know, here's one side saying such and such, another side saying such and such, some scholars are saying such and such, some other scholars say, but here when you come to the masjid, to your imam, to your scholar of Islam and say, here's what we have here, here's what I have been confronting, tell me the answer of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Especially when it comes to specific issues, living here in America, living here in Western society, not really aware of what is going on. Who can guide me? Who can help me? Who can tell me, subhanallah, what I should be doing there? So taqwa Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wal-ikhlas, the sincerity. Am I sincere enough first and foremost to my deen? And when we read Surah Al-Ikhlas, the title is sincerity. قل هو الله أحد. الله الصمد. لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. Do we know the real meaning of that surah in the Quran? And no wonder, no wonder wallahi, when you read it by itself equals to one third of the Quran you read. So meaning if you read Surah Al-Ikhlas 3 times with the full meaning of it, with the deep meaning of it, with the breadth of it, you have one third of the Quran has been read and established and you abide by it. الإخلاص to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قل هو الله أحد first and foremost. One and only one worthy worship. You do not take any partners or associate with him in any issue of your life. Yani some people say, oh, okay, I'm going to buy a house. Fine. I know that realtor is going to help me. Good. I know the locations because I have heard from many people that location is much better than this location. And alhamdulillah, I have some money. The other money I'll get, you know, a loan from the bank and so on and so forth. My wife is okay with this, or my spouse, my children, and so on and so forth. But did you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala first and foremost, why I'm having this house? Maybe majority of us never ask that question. Why I have a house? Do I need a house? And for what? What is the difference between having a house and an apartment? Especially here in this country. Oh, a house, I will own it after 20 years, 25 years, after I pay my loan and so on and so forth. But apartment, it's wasting money and so on and so forth. But you're having the house for what first and foremost? A shelter? Yes. To protect you from what? I own my place. I have the safety and security along with my spouse and along with my children. And I have that address. And first and foremost, I am having it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. First and foremost, not I own a house and I have my name on it and my spouse's name on it. And I know how much it is, how valuable it is, and so on and so forth. No. It is, Ya Allah, you told me to protect my family this way. Help me to have this. And check, you know, the issue of the finance. Check the issue of the finance. Haram, halal, take a loan, not take a loan. It's okay, you know, to do it this way, to do it Islamically or not Islamically, and so on and so forth. Follow the way of Allah. قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٌ No one to take an associate with him in anything you do in your life. Anything, wallahi. And I mean it, anything you do in your life. Allah first and foremost. That's why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the Sahaba, when they learn from him, alayhi afdal as-salatu was-salam, they learn all of these issues in the masjid. But once we have the masjid, and here it is really highly connected with that concept we're using nowadays, the leadership. The leadership. The leadership, al-qiyada. Whom am I following in my community? This masjid is turned to be what? Nowadays, as if we're speaking here in America. What the masjid is for? You know it much better than I do. I have heard the sign, money. Raise fund, collect money, have fundraising for one person or two or three, and it doesn't matter, you know. Till the point some people would say during the month of Ramadan, I'm not going to go to this masjid. This masjid is mainly the 30 nights of Ramadan, raising money, raising fund, raising money, raising fund, and I'm not part of this anymore. I'm not going to go. Ramadan, the month of very intensive worship for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Is it the way to turn the bayt of Allah during the month of Ramadan to that business? And I wish it is a successful business, wallahi. La wallahi. La wallahi. La wallahi. La wallahi. Wallahi, the masjid will be supported financially, like it or not, by the helping grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as long as you're 100% depending on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I don't have to tell you how this masjid is financed, wallahi, by people maybe you do not know them. You have never heard of them. Maybe you do not have any communication with them. Yet they are helping the masjid of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because they knew and they know and they will know we'll never have a business fundraising to support this masjid al-Iman. La wallahi, la wallahi, la wallahi. And by themselves. You have seen me, yani, how we pay our invoices, how we pay our bills. It's not that difficult to lie. It is not that. We still owe money for the bank? Yes. We did not finish the payment of the bank? Yes, no doubt about it. We're taking it so easy. But to turn the masajid to be this way, we have seen, and you tell me we have one of the best Muslim community? No. To turn it to be a business, get the money from people, wal-iyadu billah, for their hajj and for their umrah, and those who collect the money, took the money and run away with it. And when people ask for their money, they cannot get their money. Where in the world, subhanAllah, our masajid would be يعني, running like this? Those who are the favorite one to the imam, okay, come here. Anyone else, second class citizen, or third class citizen, or you, there is no place for you in here. People feel it, because people are human beings. I feel where I am from the imam, where am I from the leadership, where am I in this masjid, subhanAllah, Rabbil Alameen. Where in the other side, some people in a very, very sincere way, very sincere way, looking for anything for the masjid to be done, and they come in their own and do it. Without, wallahi, without being asked to do anything. But I want to do this for the sake of Allah. I want to help with his masjid for the sake of Allah. I want to be part of establishing this masjid for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But look at our masajid, subhanallah. And I'm not seeing all of them, especially in America, especially in the West, especially where Islam got to be flourished, got to be transmitted, got to be conveyed to people, set up the best example for people around us in order to say, yes, you are doing the best according to the way of Allah, not according to your way. And of course, abiding by the rules and regulations and the laws of the country and so on and so forth. But transforming the masjid to favoritism to some people, against some people. Subhanallah, Rabbil Alameen. Or in a very nationalistic way, or very racist way. This masjid only for those who are coming from that country and that's it. Or that race and that's it. Or those who are speaking that language and that's it. Subhanallah, Rabbil Alameen. La masjidun ussisa ala taqwa من أول يوم أحق أن تقوم فيه. This is Quran. This is Quran. This is not my saying. لمسجدٌ, a house of Allah. A house of Allah. Establishing on the taqwa of Allah. Fearing Allah. And following the teaching of Allah. Following the instruction of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have the absolute right to be part of it. أحق أن تقوم فيه. Who are there in this masjid, ya Allah? فيه رجال يحبون أن يتطهروا. In that masjid, you'll find men and women, of course. People there. They love to be what? Purified. That's it. Purified. يحبون أن يتطهروا. I am coming to the masjid in order to be purified. 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 With my old sins, my wrongdoing, everything bad in my life, come to the masjid to be purified by learning the way of Allah, learning the teaching of Allah, learning the teaching of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. If you do not find that masjid which would help you in that way, don't go to that masjid. Where, subhanallah, rabbil alameen, and I'm not wallahi criticizing, but I'm sharing with you the reality we're living in as Muslims, subhanallah. One day you'll find that imam in this masjid, following day, that imam is gone from the masjid. Why? Allahu A'lam. We do not know. What's going on? We have no idea. We have no idea. We have no idea. To be transparent. I say, wallahi, that imam, you know, is no longer there because of such and such and such. That's it. Do not leave any room for second thought or conspiracy or namima and ghiba and so on and so forth. Say, wallahi, this masjid, we have that person there, and because of such and such, we no longer have this, not okay anymore. We tell him, you know, leave and go somewhere else. That's it. That's it. Easy. Easy, wallahi. Or the Imam himself will say, I'm no longer there because of such and such. May Allah forgive me. That's it. But you leave the community burning, and I mean the world, burning. What is going on? What is happening? What is happening? All of a sudden, this masjid was such and such X and Y and Z, the imams. All of a sudden, two out and one stay. The two out, one establish another masjid. And all of a sudden, the third one establish a third masjid. Ya Allah. Why it's happening? Do we need the masjid? We do. But why three in one place, leading and teaching and educating, and all of a sudden, one live here and one live here, and we have two different. And those three, no communication whatsoever among them. This would tell us there is something wrong. And this is the qiyada, this is the leadership. Like the leadership of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. One of the worst situation ever to him himself personally, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, was about to be killed in Ghazwat Uhud. In Ghazwat Uhud. One of the most, يعني, what should I say about it? 70 of the Sahaba were killed. Shuhada and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The other group of the Sahaba ordered and command from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, stay on the top of the Jabal Uhud, the mountain of Uhud, in order to protect us against the enemies of Islam. When they see Muslims under the leadership of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, victorious in that battle, they ran down after what? The alms, after the ghanaim, in order to have their share, disobeying Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When the kuffar saw this happening, those who were defending them against Muslims come down, they came after Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, killing the Sahaba right and left, including Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, injuring him severely. We're about to be victorious in that battle. And they were victorious in that round, subhanAllah, after Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the Sahaba were victorious, subhanAllah. We're about to be killed, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And by the help and grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah supported them. But look at the Quran coming to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and to the Sahaba Ridwanullah alayhim ajma'in. In that situation, one of the worst ever, teaching Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the leader, the prophet, the messenger, and teaching the Sahaba Ridwanullah alayhim ajma'in, and read it. فَبِمَا رَحْمَةٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ لِنْتَ لَهُمْ. Allahu Akbar, Ya Allah. Allahu Akbar, Ya Allah. الله أكبر يا الله فبما رحمة من الله لنت لهم ولو كنت فظا غليظ القلب لم فضوا من حولك فاعف عنهم واستغفر لهم وشاورهم في الأمر وإذا عزمت فتوكل على الله. الله أكبر يا الله. الله أكبر. To Muhammad in the battle of Uhud, we're about to be killed, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We're about to be defeated, subhanallah rabbil alameen. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is teaching him, يا محمد, what a mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You would have deeply, deeply in your heart toward your followers, the Sahaba. Mercy. They are disobedient, Ya Allah. They will cause that battle to be lost. You're about to be killed. Ar-Rahma. 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 Are we Ruhama in our followers, in our masajid? Do you have that mercy when we have some people are in bad doing or anything? فَبِمَا رَحْمَةٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ لِنْتَ لَهُمْ. Was so decent to them. Make their relationship with you convenient and easygoing. وَلَوْ كُنْتَ فَظًّا غَلِيظَ الْقَلْبِ. If you are harsh in your relationship with them because of what they did, that heart have nothing of mercy toward them, what they do? They leave you alone. They would shy away from you. They would say, Muhammad, I have no business with him anymore. Let's go find somewhere else to follow. Let's go to another masajid to be in. Let's find another Iman to be so merciful and so lenient and so respectful for us. فَبِمَا رَحْمَةٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ لِنْتَ لَهُمْ وَلَوْ كُنْتَ فَضًّا قَلِيظَ الْقَلْبِ لَمْ فَضُّ مِنْ حَوْلِكَ. I'm teaching you, Muhammad, in a situation like this, one of the most difficult situations ever in the history of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and in Islam, with the Sahaba Ridwanullahi alayhim ajma'in. فَعَفُ عَنْهُمْ. Ya Allah, they disobey me. They left the mountain where they were protecting us. And they almost allow the enemies of Islam to kill all of us. فَعَفُ عَنْهُمْ. Forgive them. Forgive them. Yes. فَعَفُ عَنْهُمْ. Ya Muhammad. فَعَفُ عَنْهُمْ. Even if they are mistaken. Even if they did wrongdoing. This is the beauty of the leadership, ya akhwah. The leadership. Don't put yourself on the top of everyone and do whatever you want to do. I like him, you stay. I don't like it, get out of here. I don't like to see your face. You don't belong in here. This is what we have seen. فَعَفُ عَنْهُمْ. Tabukay Allah, I pardon them. خَلَصْ يَا اللَّهُ اللَّهِ, I pardon them. No, not enough, ya Muhammad. وَاسْتَغْفِرْ لَهُمْ. Ya Allah, they did the mistake. They disobeyed me. They allow us, for the Quraysh to be able to kill us. And astaghfir lahum, they can make astaghfar. Astaghfirullah. We repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Forgive us. No, you Muhammad, make astaghfar to them. Fastaghfir lahum. In sighatul amr. Fa'afu anhum. An order and command from Allah to you, Muhammad. A'afu anhum. Wastaghfir lahum. This is the leadership, ya akhwa. This is what Allah is teaching us. You did mistake, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive you and forgive me too. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help all of us overcome that mistake in our masjid, in our masjid, in our masjid. We're human being. Once in a while, there is kind of misunderstanding, a dispute, something might happen. Come together. Sit down and talk. Exchange emails. Find out what is going on. فَعَفُ عَنْهُمْ وَاسْتَغْفِرْ لَهُمْ. And a lot of people say, wallahi, that's more than enough from Rasulullah to the Sahaba in that battle of Uhud and right on till you die, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. No, wallahi, no. وَشَاوِرْهُمْ فِي الْأَمْرِ. Consult with them for any affair to Muslim in al-Madinah from now on. How come, ya Rasulullah? Yani, I order them, I give them the order to stay on the top of the mountain to protect us and disobey me. And now, ya Allah, you're telling me, consult with them. Consult with them about what? No. وَشَاوِرْهُمْ فِي الْأَمْرِ. وَشَاوِرْهُمْ فِي الْأَمْرِ. Yani, in many issues in our masajid, how many times the leadership would come to you and say, here's what we're going to do, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen, what do you think? Maybe you find one among them, the most experienced one, with expertise in that area, would tell you, no, don't do it this way, but do it this way. Don't do it this way, no, do it this way. No, let's consult with someone else. فَشَاوِرْهُمْ فِي الْأَمْرِ. And after all of this, فَعْفُ عَنْهُمْ وَاسْتَغْفِرْ لَهُمْ وَشَاوِرْهُمْ فِي الْأَمْرِ وَإِذَا عَزَمْتَ. If you already take your decision in order to keep going, now we're going to move forward. Do what after all of this? فَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ. Be heavily dependent on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ. That's it. Because you did your homework. You consulted with your own people. You did all of this, yet look at what they have done. Are we doing the same in our masajid, ya akhwa? We should, we must. In order to be the best of the best ever, in order to reach out for non-Muslims and tell them, here we are, come learn from us. Here we are, this is what we have been doing. Here we are, this is what we have been treating our followers at the leadership of that masjid or that Islamic center. This is the way, wallahi, it should. This is the way it should. لازلنا في رحاب المصطفى البر لا يبلى والذنب لا ينسى. الحمد لله وكفى وسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى. الحمد لله وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأصلي وأسلم على رسول الله صلاة وتسليما يليقان بالحبيب المصطفى النبي المجتبى صلوات ربي وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وتابعيه وتابعي تابعيه إلى يوم الدين. شيخ محمد الغزالي رحمه الله, as I told you before, this is my reference for what I have been sharing with you. Fiqh al-Sunnah, Taqwa Allah wa al-Ikhlas, first foundation to establish in a Muslim community. Al-Ikhaq al-Haqq, Tamasuku bunyanihi wa tawathaqat arkanu. Al-Ikhaq al-Haqq, the real brotherhood and a sisterhood. The real one, not the fake one. Not, assalamu alaikum, alaikum salam. Coming from my lips, never came from the depth of my heart. Assalamu alaikum, I mean it. Peace be upon you. Wa rahmatullahi, in the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa barakatuhu, blessings. Wa maghfiratuhu, forgiveness. Wa ridwanuhu, the jannah. I wish all of this when I'm greeting you by the greeting of Islam. I really mean it. I really mean it. Beside the other things we can do for each other. Al-Ikha al-Haqq. The other day, I got a text message from my dear brother Farooq telling me that Brother Abdul Karim found him passed away in his apartment in the high rise. Brother Mateen. For how long he was dead there? How much we know about him? How many people around him to know he's living by himself and he died by himself and no one knew about him? How many? The brother Munir used to come in here. This is his either fourth or fifth Friday congregation, never show up. How many one of us does have any communication with him to find out where he is or where he couldn't come? I'm just giving some examples. How much we're really, really sincere about helping each other, taking care of each other, finding out how we can help each other, how we can take care of each other, how we can, as a Sahaba of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did. The Sahaba of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did. Till the point when they migrate from Mecca to Al-Madinah, anyone living in a house of Al-Madinah, of Al-Ansar, wanted to invite someone coming from Mecca to share with him his house, his living in, his wealth, his money. Do we have, ask yourself, wallahi, a real brotherhood living here in America with those brothers and sisters around you? The third point, العدل والمساواة والتعاون. العدل والمساواة والتعاون. رسمت سياسة الأجانب دستور المدينة. As we have gone through the details of it, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم put it there in order to establish that relationship between Muslims, Muhajirin Ansar on one side, and non-Muslim of the Yahud, the tribes of the Yahud, and Al-Mushrikeen, and you name them. Al-Adl, justice. Al-Adl, no differentiation between Muslims and non-Muslim. Al-Adl. Wal-Musawah. Equity and equality, subhanallah, rabbil alamin. What ta'awun, coordination and cooperation. three foundation to that third foundation of the Muslim community there. طيب. Which one of these who are applying with non-Muslims around us? Al-Adl. Am I just with each and every single person I'm dealing with who comes to my shop or come to my business or come to my whatever with adl, with justice, as Allah is telling me? Or with Muslims, okay, you wanted this? Okay, I'll sell it for you for that X amount of money. Non-Muslim, it's more, sir. It's adl. Is it adl in business? If you sell Muslim with that price, sell it with the same price, if not less, to non-Muslims of Allah, in order to show him how lenient you are, how great you are, how decent you are as Muslims on selling and buying in your business, in your shop, in whatever. Al-adl wal-musawah wal-ta'awun. How many times we're cooperating and coordinating with non-Muslims around us? How many organizations in your communities you're part of in order to help people around? Not necessarily, oh, this is a Muslim community and this is a Muslim organization. I'm part of it. I'm a member of it. I'm very active in it. And that's it. I have no participation in any other organization around me. I do not belong to them. You want to live isolated? Be part of them. Be part of those organizations. Show them I'm a Muslim. I'm here to help in that non-Muslim organization, to help people around. It's what Allah is telling me. This is what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is telling me to do. Deliver the message of Islam through what you have been doing to non-Muslims. Deliver it. You don't have to say, oh, here is Islam. Here is Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, wa siyam, wa zakah, wa hajj. La, 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 la. No, Allah. Your action with non-Muslim. How to help. How to support. How to guide. And so on and so forth. So real and the best message ever you deliver to non-Muslim in your behavior, in your relationship with them. Your neighbors. What kind of relationship you do have with them around you? How many times you salute them? How many times you greet them? How many times you wish them, you know, happy holiday or whatever? You know? Or you live in isolation and you forget that you're living in America. Or you're having a lot of benefits around you. Tabu, do not have in Medina of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to have that dustur. If you come out and say, Wallahi, in Majl Imani, we have the dustur in Medina, we declare it, and this is what we're going to apply here in the Twin Cities. No one would listen to you. You do not have the upper hand. You're a minority. You're very few people in here. But show in your behavior, in your action, what Islam is all about. People will love you. People would come to you, subhanAllah. Read more and more if you really, really love to read and communicate with your iPhone. How non-Muslims come to Islam? How they come to Islam? Once they learn little piece about Islam, say, I love Islam. I'm willing to come to Islam. Just recently, wallahi, in Egypt, one of the most يعني, famous priests there in their church was giving a special task. Go find out what is wrong in the Quran that Muslims are believing in. That's it. That's your job. Read the Quran, 114 chapters, that 560 pages. Bring us the wrong things there. In words, not in terms of belief. In words. That word is wrong. That word is wrong, like many other did. Okay? Guess what he did? After so many years of studying, hey guys, in that church, I did not find any wrong in the Quran, and that's why Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa anna Muhammad Rasulullah, I believe in the Quran. That's it. Go find out yourself. Go find out. Subhanallah. It is the Quran there, and it is our behavior here, and it is our relationship in here. Find out. Ya ikhwa, it is very, very simple, and it is not that difficult. And don't tell me that we are not in the time of Rasulullah. Rasulullah is not among us as the leader. Sahaba are not here. We're just average people come from everywhere and we know little from here, little from here about Islam. La wallahi, la wallahi, la wallahi. Al-ikhlasu lillahi subhanahu wa ta'ala wa taqwa Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the best way ever you would have it. And then al-ikha, the real brotherhood and a sisterhood. And then treat people with justice, with equity and equality, cooperate with them, you will find yourself living in the best way ever. Here in America, let's try. And let's have Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help all of us, inshaAllah, Rabbil Alameen. Allahumma ameen, Allahumma ameen. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات يا رب العالمين اللهم اشف مرضانا وارحم موتانا وفك أسرانا وكن لنا ولا تكن علينا ولا تسلط علينا بذنوبنا من لا يخافك ولا يرحمنا اللهم برحمتك عمنا واكفنا شر ما أهمنا وعلى الإيمان الكامل والكتاب والسنة توفنا وأنت راض عنا اغفر اللهم لنا ولآبائنا ولأمهاتنا ولأخواتنا ولأخواتنا ولإخواننا في الله تعالى أحياء وأموات ولكل المسلمين أجمعين إليه هذا حلنا لا يخفى عليك وهذا ضعفنا ظاهر بين يديك فعاملنا بالإحسان إذا الفضل منك وإليك واختم لنا بخاتمة السعادة أجمعين عباد الله إن الله أمركم بثلاث وأنهاكم عن ثلاث إن الله أمركم بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وأنهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون اذكروا الله العظيم يذكركم أشكروا يزيدكم قوموا إلى صلاتكم يرحمني ويرحمكم الله واستودعكم الله.
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
حق لا إله إلا الله استقيموا استووا اعتدلوا كيف بدأ السنس والله بليز كيف بدأ السنس I do have to remind you, Wallahi, we are in a very, very critical situation when it comes to the COVID and whatever is there. I have to be exhorted. I have to be exhorted. JazakAllah khair. JazakAllah khair. Mustaqim in your soul. Allahu Akbar. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين هو الذي خلقكم من تراب ثم من نطفة ثم من علقة ثم يخرجكم طفلا ثم لتبلغوا أشدكم ثم لتكونوا شيوخا ومنكم من يتوفى من قبل ولتبلغوا أجلا مسمى ولعلكم تعقلون هو الذي يحيي ويميت فإذا قضى أمرا فإنما يقول له كن فيكون
سمع الله لمن حمدا الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم ملك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين فاصبر إن وعد الله حق فإما نرينك بعض الذي نعدهم أو نتوفينك فإلينا يرجعون ولقد أرسلنا رسلا من قبلك منهم من قصصنا عليك ومنهم من لم نقصص عليك وما كان لرسول أن يأتي بآية إلا بإذن الله فإذا جاء أمر الله قضي بالحق وخسر هنالك المبطلون الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام